Wave summation is another process our body uses to produce a stronger or weaker contraction if needed. To understand wave summation, we first have to look at a muscle twitch. Here's a graph of a muscle twitch, and we can see when the muscle fiber is stimulated, for the first fraction of a second, nothing happens. That's called the latent period. In a previous video, we went through EC coupling, or excitation-contraction coupling, meaning that just because the muscle is excited, it doesn't mean that it's contracted yet. Other steps have to happen in order for the muscle to contract. So once that latent phase is over, which is very quick, the muscle contracts very quickly and then takes longer to relax. So what our body can do is take advantage of this long relaxation period in order to produce another muscle contraction before it gets completely to rest, which will produce a stronger contraction. So let's see how that happens. So this type of wave summation is called unfused or incomplete tetanus. And I'm going to use a different picture. Here it is. So there's our stimulus. We get the contraction. There's a little latent period, but there's a contraction. Remember, it takes longer to relax, so on its way down, we send in another stimulus. Now we have the same height of contraction as we did here, but we started from a higher level. So what this contraction is doing is piggybacking on this one to produce a stronger contraction. And as this muscle starts to relax, another stimulus is sent in, and then we get this wave summation. But because it's bumpy like this, that's called incomplete or unfused tetanus. You don't feel these little bumps going up and down in your, it's happened so quickly, but this is the way we can get a stronger contraction by taking advantage of this time it takes to relax by sending another stimulus in before you have complete relaxation. But we don't even need to wait until the muscle relaxes at all. What if we stimulate the muscle at a higher frequency, where your brain is sending the impulse down a neuron to your muscles one after another, so that muscle fiber doesn't even have time to relax. Right before it can even start relaxing, another stimulus is sent, then another stimulus, then another stimulus. So this wave is not broken or bumpy, so we call this fused instead of unfused, or complete instead of incomplete tetanus. By the way, this has nothing to do with tetany or tetanus shot. It just has to do with muscle contraction. And of course, the muscle will contract stronger and stronger until it gets to its max contraction. And it will just level off at that point, no matter how many more stimuli you send in. And that is wave summation. So in the previous video, we saw that we can increase the strength of a contraction by recruitment, which means use more motor units. And we also saw in the last video that the length-tension relationship is important for a strong contraction. In this video, we saw that we can produce a stronger contraction by wave summation, meaning sending stimuli in before the muscle is able to relax. Incomplete tetanus or unfused tetanus, if the muscle does start to relax a little before it's stimulated again, or complete or fused tetanus if no relaxation is allowed to occur. And one other important part of healthy and strong contractions is something called muscle tone. And that means that our muscles are always in a state of partial contraction, ready to contract. So all of these muscles you see here and more, right, are always in partial contraction mode. They're never completely relaxed, unless there's a problem. You may have seen images or maybe a person with a stroke where their face droops down on one side. Well, all of a sudden, these muscles have lost their tone and are not partially contracted anymore. Right? But under normal conditions, these muscles are partially contracted. There's a good length-tension relationship in the sarcomeres, and they're ready for a strong, healthy contraction.